In the summer of 2002, I lived with 85 HIV-positive orphans in Nairobi, Kenya. The name of the orphanage is Nyumbani. The video presents their faces.
My name is Humphrey. I am 12 years old. I come from Nyumbani. I go to Ekima Primary School to learn there. And uncles, they help me anything I want. And
who's your friend here?
My friend is Victor Kwena and Victor Morezi.
Hi, Victor.
And Joseph. Hi. And Raphael.
And why are you here?
I'm here because
said Nyumbani has over 85 HIV-positive children now, and they have different cottages. You're in cottage
St. Catherine.
St. Catherine, and you're in
St. John.
St. John.
That's good.
Touch the soul of heaven. Can we unite a sacred lesson? Every child creates a skylight of beauty. Can you hear cathedrals falling? All the universe is calling. Cry a single child.
Hi, Martin.
From
Hi, Martin, for sure.
Heart, since the world has lost. Loneliness, journey, endlessness. Yet the promised chance remains. Gift of love could be.
I knew what he said.
So let the children remain. Children engender the rain as the river runs through fields, forever subsiding the
Martin.
What about Martin?
Martin.
Is he your friend?
Yes.
Do you like him?
Yes.
Has he been nice to you?
He gives me a
He gives you what?
Every horse along the shoreline, standing still within time, spinning on the resolve. Walking as each season passes, wonderland, the looking glasses, the secret garden shines.
Do you know what an angel is?
Yes.
What is it? What's an angel? An angel, someone who protects you?
Yes.
Yes. So that's an angel. Do you have a guardian angel?
Do
you have a guardian angel? Beatrice. Yeah? Who is that? That's what angel means. Canisa.
Maria.
Okay. So, Paul, Beatrice, do you want to say anything else?
Yes.
About James? What else could we say about James?
To pray?
Yes.
What should we pray for?
For James.
For James? Do you want to say a prayer now?
Yes.
Okay, let's say a prayer. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Loving God, we ask you to keep James in your arms, to love him, and to always remember us here at Nyumbani. We ask all these things in your name. And what do you want to pray for?
Yeah.
What would you like to say?
To dance.
To dance with the angels?
Yes.
Okay, so that is our goal for James. Good. The sun's up.
holy.
I think what happens also as a survival mechanism, you kind of build a wall around you. So you just say no to street kids or to other beggars. And even here, the patients at the hospice, at a certain point, they don't really touch you anymore. I don't want to compare them to beggars, by the way. But the amount of pain and sadness, you don't allow it to get to you anymore. And then once in a while you meet someone that really touches you, that you get a personal bond with, and then again you realize, like, oh my God, what is happening here?
Last time Winston gave me a t-shirt for HIV positive, and I was putting it on compound. People were even fearing, you know, just to pass through nearby me, you know. So it's a lot of stigma. So I don't get cheap. So if these guys really know that I'm HIV positive, how will they take me or something? Because they really fear, you know. Otherwise, help is, we need the real, true help from donors or something, you know. Because we can't find work.
Even when I was coming to this place, I was telling my friend I'm going to this center, you know, there are people living with HIV. She was like, you know, I don't really feel anything for these people because they really know what they do. And so there's no point for me to, like, sympathize with them. After all, they had eaten the money from the guys, you know, such things. So it's not important for me to feel anything for them.
How do you change someone's attitude like that, do you think?
I think it's not easy, but what I would do in my case, you know, because I'm a Christian, you know, I sometimes talk to these people, you know, don't know what happens, AIDS is for everyone. If it's not you, then any of your family members might be infected, and you are going to be affected. So I really talk to them in the sense that, you know, we just have to put everything in God's hands.
In this country, you know, the stigma is so much. If people in this country, they know that you are HIV positive, it means it's like you are an outcast. They would not want to eat with you, they would not want to shake hands with you. They would not even want, if maybe there was any support given to you, then that support is completely cut. That's why it's so difficult in this country for even people to come to know about their status. because they know that if they are going to know their status and that will be the end. If their relatives or anybody who is supporting that person knows about that, that is the end.
They don't care about him. You'd find sometimes when you are working and they hear to say you are positive, they always think of terminating your service simply because of saying that he's unhealthy and he cannot afford to work.
And what is killing us in this country is not the disease itself. But what is killing us in this country is the stigma, is the poverty, because we don't have any money. So that's why we are appealing that if there are friends outside there who can help us, please go ahead and help us.
How are we going to feed our children? How are we going to educate our children if we are not working? Even you think for loans, you cannot get a loan. A poor person like me, you can't get a loan.
Basically, what we do is to help people who are living with HIV to kind of find where to start from after the test. So when they come here, we give them some skills that will basically help them to have confidence in themselves. So most of these skills are in art, like the ones you can see here.
Jimmy.
Yeah.
Is it Jimmy?
Yes.
Can you wave, Jimmy?
We're in the boutique.
You're watching us do boutique here, yes. Oh, listen. Oh, my mother is doing the work. That's your mama. Yeah?
In the summer of 2002, I lived with 85 HIV-positive orphans in Nairobi, Kenya. The name of the orphanage is Nyumbani. The video presents their faces. Nyumbani has over 85 HIV-positive children now, and they have different cottages. You're in cottage...
St. Catherine.
St. Catherine, and you're in...
St. John.
St. John.
Let's go to you.
Hello.
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 Say hello, hello. United States.
Hello.
What's your name? What's your name? Can you say hello?
Hello. Hello. Eddie,
Pano. Yeah. Tuseme mfano. Kwa yale yote tunafanya, mazuri. Na kwa mabaya tumuulize, atuondolee.
Baby!
Oh, wait.